Hello everyone and welcome to Macula Designs. In this video I'll be teaching you 5 fundamental key principles of UI designs. These designs principles can lead you to professionalism and success in product designing. So without any further delay, let's get started. Tips 105, Hierarchy. Hierarchy refers as arrangement and presentation of website and app UI elements in order of their importance, so that users can easily scan page information and can access quickly, such as click and purchase a product smoothly. There are 2 types of hierarchies. 1. Information architecture. The example of information architecture is when a user visits the site or app, the first thing they notice is menu or top bar of mobile application. That can be called as primary sector in hierarchy terminology. Let's see this example. Oh, this is one of my web interactive design tutorial I did few weeks ago. You should definitely check out the tutorial video of this web interactive design by clicking the link above or visit the link given in the description below. Anyway, now when a user click or hover on menu, for example on women, they see furthermore submenus which can be called a secondary sector in hierarchy terminology. This secondary sector allow a user go more specific, or in other word filter their choice to get to the product they are looking for. 2. Visual hierarchy. Usually designers designs the visual hierarchy by keeping in mind that it need to be designed where more important content should stand out. What I mean by this is, in this example you see the product is the main and most important element, so it is a line in the center of the page both vertically and horizontally. Then the title of a product and that the card button are the secondary sectors. Then lastly, the product description, size, price and colors are tertiary sectors. However, you see the top bar is the navigation menu bar, which is commonly located at the top of the web page. This way it is understood for a user that this is the navigation menu as they are used to it. Try not to change those things that are wisely and commonly used in websites. Keep the consistency of your website design, because the more easily users will learn it and the better their experience will be. It is not necessary, but the principle of consistency tells us you're better off sticking to standard pattern for most things. Remember, users hardly spend 1-2 minutes on websites, so make sure you design your hierarchy very carefully that keep your visitor busy engaging with your website. Here is a small example that I'll show you how you can design your website that keep your visitor busy with your website. Here you see I gave few colors option to choose from and see the product in different colors. This way users check how the product will look like based on their chosen color. However, giving so many options can lead your visitor to laziness. So make sure to give them limited options but the powerful one. This way user will try out multiple time and keep engaging with your site. Increasing website engagement time spent by visitor and website traffic leads your website to rank up in search engine, Google search engine, for example. Tips 0205, Consistency. As I mentioned earlier in hierarchy section that keep the consistency of your website design, because the more easily users will learn it and the better their experience will be. For example, floating action button use at the bottom right corner of the mobile app to make it easy for users to accomplish the most important action available on this screen. Here is the screenshot of 3 different mobile applications in which floating action button is used in the same place, which is bottom right corner. Basically, consistency reached by using formal set of guidelines for how to design products for a particular device or format. As a designer, it is an advantage because it means you don't have to reinvent the wheel for every part of your design. For instance, if you're designing apps for iOS, you'll want to follow Apple's human interface guidelines. If you're designing apps for Android, you might want to refer to Android guidelines. Tips 0305, Confirmation. Confirmation allows a user to reverse an unintentional action or to rethink something they're not sure of. As a designer, preventing errors is one of the key goals. When user accidentally closes the application in mobile, their experience falls apart. In order to prevent this error, the best way is to ask confirmation for closing the application before the application actually closed. Let's take a look to our existing example here. For example, I forgot to select shoes size and I click on add to cart button. Now how you will tell the user if they either didn't notice or forgot the step that need to take into action before adding the product into their cart? How to prevent from this issue? Now as I forgot to select the shoes size and I click on add to cart button, you will see a message display on screen asking me confirmation of adding the product without shoes size selection. See? Now in this example I'm buying shoes, so obviously it is understood that I'll order it based on my foot size. As a designer keeping this issue under consideration, designer will make the obvious answer the highlighted one. Now you see here the button no have background color while button yes have just outline border. Why? Because it is understood that the user who will buy shoes, they will order it based on their foot size. So button no is highlight element by default. Now when I'll click on button no, it will take me back to the previous page. This time I'll take size selection step into the consideration and then I'll click on add to cart button. Confirmation action should only be used where extra effort is required, which has a significant effect. Tip 0405, user control. User control gives the opportunity to the user to control over where they are in the product or in what they're doing, in order to give them a better user experience. Taking this example again, suppose I want to see some other shoes. I'll need to go back to the page where I selected the shoes to learn more about it. In order to go back, I need something that will help me to navigate to the previous page. In this situation, user control play a role by giving a back button control option to overcome from this scenario. Another way to improve the user efficiency or user experience is by giving advanced user control, such as keyboard shortcut. Now instead of giving only a back button control, give keyboard shortcut key such as backspace key to user to navigate to the previous page. This way it will helps the user to efficiently take action to lighten up their experience with the product. Tip 0505, accessibility. Accessibility on product designing is to lead the product to its full potential that to be accessible, enabling people with disabilities to participate equally on the product. As being a UX designer, we design products in a way that will be easy for users to use and can be used by as many people as possible. Indeed, this drives the UX designers to design a product in a way that can also be used by people who have disabilities. The uniqueness in UX designer's role is the focus on removing the obstacles for people when they use the product, whether those obstacles are temporary or more permanent. Now how accessibility design principle is used in this example? Placing select size text label helps screen readers read them for visually impaired users, while it reminds all users to take this action before adding the product into their shopping cart. Another example of accessibility in this example is high contrast between text and background color such as in add to cart button. The background color is yellow and text is bold white. This helps both users with visual impairments and users in low light settings read text on screen. So here comes the end of the video section. If you have any argument on any of my tip point or have better tips, then please share it in the comment section below. It will be great learning for me to have a feedback from you guys and to know what you guys think of these tips. If you do enjoy this video and find helpful, then give a video thumbs up and do share it. If you haven't subscribed my channel yet, then do subscribe and click the bell icon in order not to miss any future useful videos from my channel. Thank you and see you in the next video.